market at record high, not in sync with the current economic realities. Is it a reason to worry? Hello and welcome to Inventiva. This is Sonia Gatraj back again with the big news. Domestic equities have been trading at their all-time high level lately, even as the macroeconomic indicators have been slashing signs of stress and the COVID-19 pandemic remains a looming risk. The market suffered sharp losses in March 2020 when the pandemic started weakening a havoc. The government announced a complete lockdown, which brought the economic activities to a standstill. The sentiment of the market was totally shattered. However, in line with the global fears, the Indian government and the RBI were quick to announce measures to support the economy and the market itself. A massive influx of the liquidity and steep cut in the lending rates cheered the market, which was reflected in the sharp jump in key equities indices. Nifty has jumped 111% from its March 2020 low, which Sensex has checked again of 107%. Mild and small caps have been outperformed the frontline stocks. BSE mid cap has jumped 125% in the 2020 itself, as much as 183% in the same period. India's gross domestic product of the financial year 2021 contracted by 7.3%. The market has been reeling in the calendar year 2021, bearing small casualties, while the second wave of the COVID-19 has significantly dented the pace of the economic recovery. Fitch Rating has cut India's growth forecast to 10% for the current fiscal from 12.8% estimated earlier due to slowing recovery post second wave of the COVID-19. Rating agencies CRISIL has received in forecast downward of India's GDP growth by 9.1% from 11% projected earlier. Moody's Investor Services believes that the Indian economy can clock a growth of 9.3% in FY22. Retail inflation has started to move higher. In May, India's retail inflation came in 6.3%. The inflation prints from June, which is expected to be released on July 12, may be even higher owing to a sharp uptick in the fuel prices. Rahul Bajoria, Chief India Economist of Barclays India, experts of CPI inflation to rise to 6.7% in June, with the core inflation moving to 7%, a 7-year high, communicating its tolerance for high inflation will remain a challenging task for the central bank, Bajoria said. The economic indicators are expected to improve in the coming days as the COVID cases have declined sharply and restrictions have been eased. Besides, the government is aggressively increasing the pace of vaccination, which is expected to bring the pandemic under control. The rich valuation of the market is not as always serious sign of worry, as most analysts and brokerages expect earning upgrades, which may sustain the valuation. While the Nifty is not cheap at current levels, it is very expensive either, especially given the fact that we are in the early phase of the recovery cycle where multiples and to be higher, said Jyoti Roy, DVP Equity Strategist, Angel and Broking underscored. As we are in the early phase of the recovery cycle, there is a possibility of earning upgrades down to the line, which will make Nifty valuation reasonable, said Roy. However, policy normalization by the central bank is a fact which may occur sooner than expected, and it may roil the market sentiment as usual. While the US Fed has already said that at least 2 rate hikes are possible by the end of 2023, RBI has maintained to keep the rates low and for a longer time. However, rising inflation may pose a challenge to RBI and make it rethink its stance on the monetary policy. The RBI Monetary Policy Committee might begin to express more concerns over inflation at the August rate review. As the second wave abates and vaccination rate catches up on better supplies, the central bank is likely to outline normalization plans from 4Q21, said DBS Bank of Reports. Communication will be a key to ensure financial tightness doesn't run from an indeed speed of normalizing policy in phasing the normalization does not equate tightening, it said. The market has offered a short-term concerns too, such as falling rupee and hardening bond yields. but in the long term, the market is likely to scale fresh peaks as the economy looks set to clock rapid growth. While India is currently lagging developed markets, the return of the global growth and private capex, structural reforms and continued pro-cyclic policy support bodes well for the economic recovery ahead, said a report from the NYC Wealth Research. While downside risk from the third wave subsided credit and general sense of risk aversion remain, India's growth story is expected to pick up significantly in effect. Nifty FY22 earning growth estimate stands at an impressive 42%, says analysts.